As more people throughout the state continue to catch the H1N1 flu, there are still a lot of unanswered questions about the symptoms, the vaccinations, the side effects, and the treatments. Live look at our special H1N1 section tonight on WMTW.com. And we asked you to send in some of your questions about this flu. Tonight, News 8 gets some answers with the help of a local expert. Closer look tonight with News 8's Keith Baldi. Keith.
Tori, there's a lot of information out there about the swine flu and the two types of vaccinations, but still a lot of questions, too. One of the reasons is because there are so many variables when it comes to who is most vulnerable, who should get the vaccine first, and when they'll be able to get it. Tonight, questions from viewers and the answers.
It's a global pandemic that has many people, parents in particular, panicked about their children's health and their own well-being. And at WMTW.com, News 8 web viewers have been submitting their questions and concerns about the swine flu. Now, Nurse Gwen Rogers, Maine Med's Director of Epidemiology and Infection Prevention, provides some answers. First, to this question. I'm afraid to have my younger daughter vaccinated because she is smaller and I know the mist has the live virus. Should I wait until there is enough of the shot available and hold off on the mist?
You should really discuss with your pediatrician whether it's the right formulation for your child, but if it is available and it is okay for your child, it's important to get it.
Rogers says common side effects of the flu mist are nasal congestion, fever, and headache, but she says significantly milder than the actual flu, so if appropriate, fully consider it. Next, my son has had the swine flu. It was a confirmed diagnosis. Should he still get vaccinated or not?
If there's a confirmed case of H1N1, they will have immunity to that particular strain of the virus, so they do not need to have the H1N1 vaccine.
Rogers says if you suspect your child had swine flu but never confirmed it, check with your doctor. They may recommend you still get the vaccination, although side effects may be stronger. Also, everyone should still seriously think about getting the seasonal flu shot. Question number three. Our daughter developed a confirmed case of H1N1. Is it common to develop a lingering cough after symptoms are gone?
It can be a prolonged cough after H1N1 or seasonal flu.
But if fever returns and accompanies the cough, the patient gets worse, or there's wheezing or trouble breathing, Rogers says call a doctor.
As far as vaccine availability, Rogers says pediatricians and obstetricians are now getting the flu shot and mist, so call about availability. Also, many offices are putting people on waiting lists, so call to sign up. For more information, check out our website at WMTW.com, where there's an H1N1 link right at the top. Live in the newsroom, Keith Baldi, News 8.